What's up? I'm going to show you how to make laser effects for your brick films.
So first, set up your three-point lighting. You're going to want your backlight, your key light, and your fill light. Use any kind of recording software. I use DragonFrame, but there are other options. Set your camera to manual for those crispy exposures. Now, grab your figure, or your figures, or this guy.
Just like the simulation.
Set your figure in the frame, and make his gun point up like this. Make his gun recoil like this. Here's a slow-mo. Now we're going to make the muzzle flash. So you're going to want to grab a flashlight or any kind of light source. Grab some lighting gels or any kind of see-through colored paper. Slap that bad boy on your flashlight, shine it at your subject, and take a picture for every time your subject shoots. This is without muzzle flash, and this is with muzzle flash. Once you have your footage, you want to go into any kind of compositing software. This is Hitfilm. Make a composite shot and name it anything you'd like cheeseburger or lasers. Import your footage and you're ready to go. Now, let's make that muzzle flash. Right click the timeline, add a new layer, make a new plane, select the pen tool, and make a candy corn shape. Like, you know, those like Halloween candies. It looks a little rough, but that's okay. It doesn't have to be perfect. So you don't have to make a candy corn shape. You can do a star or a oval, a rectangle, octagon. Whatever floats your boat. Let's add some special effects. Click your effects tab and add the light sword glow effect to your mask. To add color, you want to click the inner and outer glow and change the color to whatever color you would like. So a cool tip, change the blending mode to add so you get this nice glowing effect. Go into your mask and then your shape and then change the feathering to 25. This will get rid of those harsh edges. So you can play around with the settings. I like to change the width of the glow. It depends on your taste. Make your muzzle flash 2 or 3 seconds. Click transform and then hit the path keyframe, and you want to grab each path and bring it closer, so you want to swallow the muzzle flash. You should end up with something like this. To make this better, we're going to use the roundness tool, so you're going to select the keyframe, hop over a couple of frames, and bump it up to 100.